And today I'm going to show you what you need for a 0 to 3 months baby.
Okay,
so some people might just tell you around 10-15 items that you need for your baby. But darling, that's not what you need. You need a very big list of things. Okay, probably not all the things I have are essential, but they've helped me. So let me just tell you what all do we need. Okay, so these are a bunch of things. Not actually a bunch of things, a lot of things I used for my baby. Not everything is required. You will have to see for your baby what suits him or her. And you know, then probably buy a lot of things. But basic things I'll tell you. Brands, obviously you can switch the brands, whatever brands you like according to your budget, according to your taste. Maybe you want to go for higher end brands, maybe you want to go for lower end brands. So that actually depends on your budget. So I've divided my list into 7 sections. Firstly, let's talk about feeding section. If you're breastfeeding your child, thumbs up. You hardly need anything. Probably a breast pump, but that you will have to see for yourself if you require. Please do not buy a breast pump. I would suggest don't buy a breast pump before the baby is here, because you don't know. Do you really need it or not? If you're doing feeding like I was doing to my son, like I was breastfeeding him plus I was giving him formula milk once or twice a day because my body needed that rest. I had a C-section. Obviously, baby was waking up every hour or 1.5. So I gave him bottle feed from, I think, day one. Okay, so my baby was bottle fed from the very first day in the hospital. While I was in the recovery room, my baby was in the nursery. So the doctors already at the hospital gave him formula milk. So that's when I knew, you know, that I think it's okay because the doctors did so. But if you're trying to, switch like I was doing, I was giving him formula, I was giving him breast milk, I was giving him a combination of both, my son. So if you're planning to do something similar, or probably even if you're planning to give your baby breast milk, and sometimes breast milk don't come immediately, and then you have to have a formula. That I think formula you will get from your hospital. One bottle you will probably get from your hospital if not, there's a chemist in the hospital, you can always go and buy it. First thing you need is a formula milk. You can use any formula. This was suggested to us by our doctor. It's Nan Exela Pro in one number. It's usable for 0 to 6 months baby, and then you switch to number 2. And we were very satisfied with this milk, and we continued to give him this milk till after he was 1 year old. Okay, so next up is a bottle. You can use any bottle. This is the bottle that we used. It's from Dr. Brown. It's a glass bottle, and it's anti-colic bottle. So that's what we loved about it. And the next thing along with this is the sleeves from Dr. Brown's itself. Okay, so this is how the sleeve looks like. So if you feed your baby in public or in front of anyone, all your mother-in-laws, mothers or elderly ladies will tell you, please cover your bottle of milk. No one should know how much milk your baby is having. So you know, that's why I got the sleeve. Okay, so the next thing I have is this powder milk container. It's again from the brand Dr. Brown. Okay, I have already talked about this product in my What's in My Diaper Bag video. If you haven't watched it already, please have a look at it and you'll understand what it is required for. Okay, so the next thing I have is this flask from Milton. This is the thermosteel range. It keeps your water warm for, I won't say 24 hours, but yes, around 18 hours. It's good. Whatever temperature water you have, it'll stay as it is. Okay, next thing, a burp cloth. Basic burp cloth, nothing fancy. Just put it over here and then you put your baby to your shoulder, and whatever spit or vomit, whatever your baby is doing, it'll come directly into your work cloth, and obviously your outfit won't get dirty. That's it, basic. Next up, we have this bib. It's from Mother Care, and it's a bandana bib. A basic bib is what you need. Even if you're breastfeeding, a bib is what you need. Don't have a burp cloth handy at all times. Even a basic hand towel would do the same thing. Again, I think it will give you more coverage than your burp cloth will. So this is what you need. Okay, so the next thing you need is a sterilizer. The sterilizer we use is from the brand called Philips, and the best thing about it is you can take 6 bottles, or you can sterilize 6 bottles at a time, which is actually very good, because being a new mom, you will not get a lot of time to go and clean each and every bottle and individually sterilize each and every bottle, which is obviously a waste of electricity. Okay, this is the next thing I want to show. Okay, this is not an essential. I wouldn't say you have to buy it, but it is a lifesaver in my opinion. You must be wondering what grass kind of a thing this is. Yes, I called it the grass. I don't remember the name. I will definitely post the name of this product. I got this from Amazon. So I'll tell you how it's used. When your bottles are cleaned, washed, you can just place your bottles to air dry like this without any germs. Your bottle will fix over here. The nipple will go like this. So the last thing you need in your feeding section is a bottle cleaner. Very important. Other than that, you need a brush. What I use for cleaning the bottle, I will show you later. Into the second section, which is the sleep solution. Okay, so the next thing is very important, that you should already have a plan in mind that where is your baby going to sleep. Is he or she going to co-sleep in your bed? Or is he or she going to sleep in a crib or a playpen, or whatever you guys prefer? You should always have that thing in your mind, that where is the baby going to sleep. Okay, so you need to have a day bed for your baby. If you're going here and there in your room and you don't want your baby to be alone in your room, so definitely you need something for your baby which you can probably carry from one room to another. Obviously, we had to buy a mosquito net kind of a thing, which has a bed. I will share the picture if I have. Okay, so what I used on a day-to-day regular basis was this thing. Please don't mind, it's dirty. I hope you guys can see. If you know what a Dockotot is, this is a Indian version of a Dockotot. I was asking for a Dockotot, but obviously it's not available in India, and I could not get my hands through it. So I was very satisfied with this particular product also. It's from an Instagram page, Little Mulberry, and it's a reversible bed. You just have to turn this like over here, and I think till 6 months, Ivan was sleeping in this. Even when he was in his crib, he was sleeping in this kind of a bed, and then he was put into, I used to put this bed into the crib, and even if he was sleeping on our bed with us, again in the same bed, I used to put Ivan. I don't know where I've kept all his newborn stuff. Okay, so this is also one of the pillows that we used for Ivan in his initial days. It's a mustard seed pillow. As you all know, only mustard seed pillow can be given to a baby, a newborn. So till the time he was fine with this one, we gave him this one, and as he outgrowed this one, so we changed his pillow to another pillow, which I told you I can't find. Next up, I have this cute little blanket that we use is a swaddle. This is a very basic swaddle. It was a gift. It's from Disney Baby. Okay, this is one kind of a swaddle that we used. We just used this as a swaddle. We used it for 2 months. I think that was the only time Ivan actually liked to get swaddled. After that, he would, you know, just keep on crying, taking his hands out and, you know, unwrap himself somehow or the other. And this is just for 2 months that we used. The swaddling thing that we did was only for 2 months. After that, Ivan did not like swaddling, so we had to stop it. If you don't know how to swaddle, like I didn't know, so the other thing you can use is a pre-stitched swaddle. If not a swaddle, you can also buy a sleep bag for your baby. That also comes in very handy. Okay, so the next thing I have in my hand is a quick dry sheet. It is not actually a sleep solution, but if you are making your baby sleep diaper free because of some reason or the other, or you're making your baby wear nappies, then you definitely need this. Otherwise, your bed and everything will get spoiled in minutes. And coming to the next section, which is diapering. I think diaper or nappy, up to you, your call. I actually used both, and I used a third thing also, which I'll show you in a bit. Okay, so the thing with nappy, which I don't really like, is it leaks, and the baby is all wet, he's sleeping, and the baby will start crying in the middle of the night. According to me, diapers are very handy, you know, and not just for you as a mother, even for your baby. I think I wouldn't say it's hygienic, but yes, it is convenient for both you and your baby. First thing we have is obviously a diaper. We use Pamper Premium pants. As I've already told, my baby is now in the size XL. So coming to diapers, I have used these Pamper Premium pants from, I think, day one. You can obviously see what you like. Pant style diapers are very convenient to use than the other diapers. That's why we use this. The thing I have is this plastic bag. I never throw Ivan's diaper without this kind of a bag into the dustbin, because it's unhygienic and it smells really bad. If not this, this roll-on diaper bag, garbage bag, it comes like this. You just have to open it, take one out, and just put the dirty diaper and knot it up and throw it. Next thing after diaper is a very essential thing, which is a diaper cream. You can use anything which you like. Sebamed has got a really nice diaper cream, but the only problem I had with it was it used to leave a lot of white residue, which I didn't really like. My baby's clothes got dirty because of that, and probably when he got that big rash I was talking about. So after that, I really wanted to switch to other things also and see. So when I got my hands onto this particular thing, which is the Aquaphor baby healing ointment, I think I hardly use anything else. Just one diaper cream that I use other than this is Burt's Bee diaper cream. Again, white residue, but it's really good. So I use it sometimes, especially when I'm traveling, because it's a small packing and this is hard to carry. Okay, so next thing is a applicator, a diaper cream applicator. I showed this particular thing. It's a lifesaver in the video what's in my diaper bag also. Cleaning solution, water wipes, highly recommended. Only wipes I use. I don't use any, I haven't used any other wipes other than this particular. Okay, so the next thing I have in my hand are these Kiko cotton square. So as I told you, Ivan had a very severe rash when he was born, and I think it was a heat rash, and it was a major rash, and I didn't even wanted to use those water wipes. Okay, it's just a cotton square, nothing fancy about it. You can take normal cotton also, but these are travel friendly. You can actually use them while you're traveling. And that's what I did. I never used them at home. Okay, so the next thing I learned the hard way, nappy. Very hard for me to put my baby onto a nappy. Next up are some nappies. Basic nappies. You have to put them, tie them like this somehow. I don't know. Available and printed and plain white as you like. Different colors are available. I am somebody who has never imagined my baby in nappies. And it was very shocking to me that my baby has to wear nappies now. But it was for, I think, 15-20 days or a month or something, like a month said. Learn things the hard way. These came in handy. Yeah. Nappies with diapering solution. Nappy pads. Last thing in this section is a changing mat. Not a essential, but really good for baby massages, for changing diapers. We use it, if you can see, it's new till now because this is our second purchase. First one got destroyed in a year, and I think after a year, probably after 11 months, I had to repurchase a new one. This is from Mother Care.
So since this video is going to be too long if I make it in one part, so I'm planning to do it in a two-part section. So the remaining four sections I'm going to cover in the next video. See you next time. If you like this video, please like, share and subscribe to my channel.